perhaps your friend would like to join us?
Comrades, brother and sister at arms, so to speak.
Get a load of the loony bird over there. Bite your tongue, Francois. A pity if you'd have lit the one less fortunate than you. As dedicated public servants, we should refrain from using such epithets.
I'm sorry, Inspector.
No less, I'm still ashamed of you. Go, wait in the car, and never let me hear you say loony bird again.
Yes, sir.
Bow.
I see you are an archer. May I see your bib?
Bib?
Yes, your bib.
I'm a bib.
It's right there in your hands. Bib. Ah, yes. A fine weapon. And deadly in the right hands. Do you see that limb which angles down over the bed?
No.
Keep your eye on it.
Nice shot. You get a scalper?
Get out of here, you loony bird. Do not be afraid, mon ami. I will help you.
Oh, God. Clouseau.
Hey, yes, there is no need to thank me.
Thank you.
I removed the arrow. You seem to have received a large bib.
Bib?
What?
He said bib.
Ah, yes. Such a bib could be serious. Might have a concussion.
What are you doing here? Have you been committed?
No, old friend. I am not the lunatic. I have come to sprinkle the stardust of friendship over this neurotic landscape. Let me have a look at you. A picture of health, eh? Not like the last time I saw you.
Yes, I was under a great deal of stress.
Ah, you should feel no shame because you could not handle the rigors of the job of chief inspector. Better men than you affect under the pressure.
I think I'll sit down.
Well, let me help.
Oh, no. It's all right. Probably just a shock. A surprise of seeing you again. Here, today.
Ah, yes. Let it all out, my old friend. I knew the reunion to be an emotional one. We are forced to be strong. Stoic for the public. We dare not cry. But now it is just two old friends. Two old friends sharing a common bond. So let there be tears. Tears without shame.
Do you honestly believe what you are saying? That we are friends?
Friends and more. That is why I was so crushed when you were reduced to a raving lunatic.
What do you think it was that drove me to lunacy?
Pressure, my old friend. Pressure and a hormonal imbalance. But you should feel no shame. Some men are born to lead, and some to follow.
And you, old friend, a leader, eh? Onwards and upwards, to the top.
It is my karma.
What?
My destiny.
Oh.
Who knows, a few more years and I might be persuaded to run for public office.
You've got my vote.
To think that you would do this for me. Most women in your position would be bitter and vindictive.
Yes, very.
After all, I've taken over your former job, and all the glory and prestige that goes along with it. Well, you, a shadow of your former self, have been cast aside in disgrace. I sit on a lofty pinnacle, basking in the adoration of my peers and the people of France. Well, you are forever forced to bear the scars of your lunacy. But do you wish me ill?
No.
To think that you would honor me with your vote. I shall do everything in my power to see that you are removed from this loony bib.
Oh.
Let me help you, my lady.
I think you should be going now.
Ah, yes, I'm just stopping in for a moment.
What are you doing?
There seems to be a fly. Don't move, my baby. It has landed right on your nose.
No! No! No!
Ah! I have got the filthy beast. Allow me to help you.
Every day, every way, I'm getting better and better. The
I'm afraid. afraid it's just not your day, old friend.
But it is my day. After 3 long, terrible years, it is at last my day. I do not permit anything to spoil it. Now, I'll walk you to your car, eh? And I will kiss you goodbye, eh? And you'll drive off in your brand new car that should rightfully be mine, eh? And I'll have the interview with the sanity board, and it'll let me play, eh? And then?
Yes.
I'll kill you, eh?
Jarvis, I told you I didn't mind you moonlighting, as long as it didn't interfere with my household.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again. You rang, ma'am?
Father's having trouble sleeping. Would you warm some milk for us?
Yes, ma'am. Right away.
With a smidgen of sugar and vanilla extract.
Yes, ma'am.
You're excused.
Don't bother with Jarvis, dear. He's just a little, you know.
Father, you look exhausted. As soon as your meeting with the NATO representatives is completed, I'm sending you to Blackpool, where you will spend 2 weeks in a beach chair without one single word of that silly old doomsday machine.
I wish you wouldn't call it that, pumpkin.
Well, you know what I mean. Now, might I suggest we retire to the library where we can have our milk, after which I demand you get some sleep so I make myself quite clear.
Abundantly clear.
Take all your fingers out.
One moment, sir. The deputy commissioner.
Yes, ma'am. This is Chief Inspector Jacques Doucet speaking and defend. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, right away. I shall take the necessary precautions. Yes, sir. Good evening, Deputy Commissioner. Hang up for me. Yeah. How very careless of you, my little friend. You forgot the first rule of self-defense. Never do your enemy a favor. Now stand up. The Deputy Commissioner has just informed me that the lunatic Dreyfus has escaped from the insane asylum. He thinks she may try to kill me. Obviously, she's crazier than anyone had thought. I've been ordered to take the necessary precautions. I want you to lock all the doors and windows and make sure no one gets in. Do that while I change into my new hunchback disguise. What do you think? What are you laughing at, you idiots? This is a guaranteed disguise. No one will recognize you or your money back. Now, lock the doors and windows. Oh, before you go, did Yvette call about the theater?
Ah, she said she could not make it. Her goldfish died, and she is too heartbroken to go out.
Kitty? Did Gina call about our engagement?
Ah, she said she could not make it. Her rabbit died, and she is too heartbroken to go out.
Kitty? Did Paulette call about next weekend?
Ah, she said to tell you she could not make it. She said she was dead.
Kitty, she was such a vibrant girl. Go, lock the doors and windows. I must send my condolences. The bell! The bell! Sanctuary! What do you think?
Someone named Duval is here to see you.
I thought I told you not to let anyone in. Send them away. Wait. What does this person want?
Ah, want to present you with an award.
An award? For me? Send them in.
Perfectly so. I have the honor of presenting you with an award.
An award? To what effect?
Services to honor you as one of the city's most brave and dedicated public servants.
Why, thank you. Would you care for a seat? Better interest you in some wine.
No, I'm not here for wine. Wine does not matter. What matters is the dreadful treatment you've received at the Thursday. 9 faithful years of service. Have you received so much as a decoration or a commendation?
Well, now that you mention it, no. Ah, but I've recently received an important promotion.
Really?
As you know, are no doubt aware, I've recently replaced the lunatic Dreyfus as chief inspector. Kato, come show Madame Duval to the door.
You called, Inspector?
I am the inspector, you idiot. Show Madame Duval to the door.
Ah, no, it's all right. I can find my own way out. I can be the new inspector. Best of luck to you.
Thank you. I shall treasure your devotion always.
That person looked familiar. That person looked like Inspector Dreyfus.
Dreyfus may be many things, but she is not a one-eyed hunchback.
It could have been a disguise.
Are you forgetting who is the chief inspector? Now, put this in my bedroom.
This package is ticking. I think it's a bomb.
Why would the presentation committee award me with a bomb? Now go, put that in my bedroom. Your poodles.
I beg your pardon?
Poodles. You have poodles outside and I've stepped in one. It is very hard to concentrate on crime when one has a wet foot. I am Chief Inspector Jacques Lussard, the Sûreté.
Yes, we've been expecting you. This is McLaren. And I'm Drummond from Scotland Yard. Are you all right? Would you care to sit down?
No, that will not be necessary, Mrs. Yard.
Drummond.
Ah, yes, and how is Scotland these days? My grandfather on my mother's side was Scottish. Hoot, ma laddie, it's a braw bright moonlight night tonight.
Yes, well, I suppose you've been informed about the Fassbender kidnapping.
Yes, most disturbing. Who would do such a thing?
That's what we hope to find out.
Ah, yes. I hope you called ahead and had the staff assembled. I need to remind you, time is of the essence.
Excuse me, sir. May I take your hat and coat?
Yes, if you could just hold the shoe.
Yes, sir.
Wait. Who are you?
Jarvis, sir.
And what is it you do?
I'm the butler.
Ah, the butler. And where were you the night of the kidnapping?
I was knocked unconscious, sir.
Can you prove it?
No, I'm afraid you're going to have to take my word for it.
I see. Now, I suppose you are all one
experience.
Now, as I was saying...
You suppose we were all wondering?
Yes, I know what I was saying. There's no need to speak unless I ask you a question. What is your name?
I'm Shulk, the gardener.
And what is it you do?
Well, I'm the gardener.
Why didn't you say that in the first place?
I did.
Did be funny with me, monsieur? This is a serious matter, and everyone in this room is under suspicion.
Rim?
What?
Well, you said rim.
Yes, I know that. And there's a good chance someone in this room knows something more about the murder than he or she is telling.
Murder?
What was that you said?
I said murder.
What murder?
I don't know, but you said murder.
I said murder, you said murder.
No, I said murder because you said murder.
I said murder.
You said someone in this room knows more about the murder than he or she is telling.
Ah, yes. What is your name again?
Shulk.
The cook.
The gardener!
Ah, yes. Now we are getting somewhere. You! What is your name? What?
She's Mrs. Stuttersuck.
Ah, I was asking Mrs. Stuttersucker. And what is it you do?
She's the beekeeper.
What is she telling you?
She says she's got a bit of a cold and she's lost her voice.
I see. Well, what have we got here? We have a beekeeper who's lost her voice, a cook who thinks he's a gardener, and a witness to a murder. What is she telling you?
She says if you swat at that bee, it'll sting you.
I suggest you let me worry about that.
Ah! You went and chased it up my chest!
Do not worry, I am a trained professional. When we are done, I suggest you count your bees. You may find one of them is missing.
Your behavior is not acceptable, Inspector. Your actions are too short and reprehensible.
I have done nothing less than what any other dedicated public servant would have done. What is she telling you?
She says you're nothing more than a common killer.
I am the chief inspector.
But that was an apis mellifera, prize colonial hymenoptera.
Not anymore, now it's just a smear on the floor.
I suppose you'll be taking out your rubber hoses next?
And what is your name?
Mrs. Levelily.
And I presume you're the housekeeper?
Yes. I was with the Fassbenders for over 30 years now, and never once has there been an act of violence in this house. And now, this?
Your exaggerated hysteria over a blemish on the floor is questionable. What has happened here can be easily repaired. What has happened with the Fassbenders is an entirely different matter. It's my job to bring the party or parties at fault to justice.
Excuse me, Inspector, but do you have any more questions for me?
Why, have you something to hide?
No, I have a previous engagement.
And where is this engagement?
The Mirage Club. It's downtown.
And what do you do at this Mirage Club?
Around First Nation, 200 a week.
That, monsieur, is your problem.
Exactly. Can I go now?
Yes. I may speak with you later.
Maybe you can catch my axe sometime.
Yes, perhaps.
Inspector?
Nobody leave this room. I have a feeling something is about to crack wide open.
Jacques. May I call you Jacques?
No.
Inspector, then. You're allowed to believe that you had a theory.
And who was it that led you to believe this?
Your superiors.
Then I do have a theory.
Would you mind filling us in?
Well, what do we know? We know that one, there has been a kidnapping. Two, Dr. Fassbender and his daughter have been kidnapped. And three, whoever did the kidnapping is probably a criminal.
You tell.
Amazing deduction.
So we know the what. Now we must decipher the why, and that will hopefully lead us to the who.
Could you be a little more specific, Inspector?
The transvestite butler did it.
Why don't we just tell Paris that he's incompetent and request to be taken off the case?
Because we have enough troubles with Paris without telling them that the greatest inspector is a fool.
The butler did.
In sleep he sang to me, in dreams he came. That voice which calls to me and speaks my name. And do I dream again? For now I find the phantom of the opera is there inside my mind. Sing once again with me your strange duet. My power over you grows stronger yet. And though you turn from me and glance behind, the phantom of the opera is there inside your mind. Those who have seen your face draw back in fear. I am the mask you wear, it's me they hear. My spirit and your voice in one combine. The phantom of the opera is there inside your mind. Beware the phantom of the opera. In all your fantasies, you always knew that man and mystery were both in you. And in this labyrinth, where night is blind, the phantom of the opera is there inside your mind. He's here, the phantom of the opera.
What are you gonna do blackboard.
Something so terrible, so hideous, that you'll have no choice but to cooperate.
I'm afraid you underestimate me, madam.
Oh, not at all, Doctor. There's no way to underestimate a father's love for his tender treasure. You have the stomach for what must be done. Sleep now.
Good God!
All right, I'll cooperate with you.
What?
I said I'll cooperate with you. I'll do anything, but please, no more of that.
Not as long as I have your complete cooperation.
Oh, yeah.
Release them, Tournier. Bring Margot to her quarters. She looks like she needs some rest.
Tournier? Are you the bank robber? Unfortunately.
You, Professor, proceed to the laboratory. There's much work to be done.
The money you hope to gain from this? Fame? Or just an incredible lust for power?
There's only one thing I want. With your doomsday machine in my possession, the world will deliver him to me on a silver platter.
Him?
Yes. Him. If so... Got a call from the boys in London, boss. They want to know what tools the rabbi had on the inside for kidnapping Fassbender. Jarvis, the butler. I think we're safe. There's no one dumb enough to think the butler did it.
Yes, there is. Eliminate Jarvis at once. The sooner the better.
Whatever you say, boss, I'll give him the word.
It's only seen. hell who cannot seem to give. And the soul of bread abiding, then never learns to live. When the night has been too lonely, and the road has been too long, then you think that love is all.
Monsieur, I suggest you watch your step.
I'm sorry, Inspector. It's just that I've heard in France you're known as the King of the Tango.
Tango?
I'd love to.
That's my last tango. I must ask, tell you something, Inspector.
What is it, Jarvis?
Have you ever been to the Oktoberfest?
No.
Well, you must go to Munich. You must go to Munich.
Munich?
Allow me to introduce myself.
You are Chief Inspector Jacques Cousteau of the Sûreté.
Have we met before?
No, but I know all about you. I probably know more about you than you know about yourself. I know your habits, your hang-ups, your likes, and your dislikes. I know that you failed geometry 3 years in a row, and your nickname in high school was Kamikaze.
But how did you know this?
It's my duty to know.
Your duty?
Yes, you must not go to Munich.
Well, then, you do your duty and I'll do mine.
Yes, I will, whether I love you or not.
Love? Me?
Yes, I prided myself on the single-minded determination to become the best in my field. And love was nothing more than a silly word, a word used by impassioned romantics. But then face stepped in, I found your file in my desk one morning. At first, it was just a jumble of words that I learned by rote like so many others. But then, as I became more and more familiar with you, something hit me. I was frightened, sick, and confused. I lost my appetite. I would leave my office at lunch and walk 3 blocks down Minsky Prospect to smell the flowers. I took down my poster of Lenin and put yours in his place. For no reason at all, I would listen to my Dr. Zhivago 33 RPM record and cry like a baby. I, Olga Borosova, was falling in love. And now here I am, and here you are. Well, my bushka. Enough. I must control myself. Do not go to Munich. You will be putting yourself in grave danger.
Well, if you know all about me, then you know I must go where my duty leads.
As I knew you would.
You're a very beautiful woman.
No, you mustn't. It only makes what I have to do all the more difficult. There's only one thing more powerful than love, and that is duty. You of all people understand that.
But of course.
I would hope you'd understand. I cannot! I will spare your life just one time, Jean Pousseau. Forget about Munich.
What a woman. I've been waiting all my life for a woman like that. A woman of such fire and strength, and beauty and strength. Such a woman could make most men forget their duty. But I am not most men.
More's the pity.
Once again, with another callus on my heart, I'm forced to follow my head. And still, a voice cries out.
Sucker.
And it says, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. I am off to Munich. I thought you were dead.
Not quite.
Chief, please.
Really think this is going to work, boss?
Of course it will work. Any moment now, my face will be on every television screen in the world, thanks to Dr. Pasta.
Hurry it up, please. 30 seconds there.
Okay. That enough?
I can't breathe.
A little stage fright, boss.
Calloway, Fran. Quiet on the set. The dance falls on, start at receptor beam. Translation starts in 10 seconds.
Peoples of the world, do not adjust your sets. You will find that I'm on every channel. This also applies to those of you hearing me on the radio. It is in your best interest to listen carefully to what I have to say, for verily the future of your planet depends on your response. I come to you this evening with a trivial request. But should my request not be met, results will be anything but trivial. I suppose it is safe to assume that any woman who can control every communication satellite in the world has a vast and awesome power at her disposal. Very true. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. I mentioned a request. Perhaps a better word would be demand. I want this man, Jacques Rousseau of the French Sûreté. I don't want him alive, or better yet, dead. But I want him, and if I don't get him, all of you will pay very dearly for it. No doubt there are those of you who doubt my powers, and so, tomorrow, at 3 o'clock, Eastern Standard Time, the United Nations building will disappear from the face of the earth. Take heed, mankind. Bring me Jacques Rousseau, or suffer the consequences.
And now, Sarah, with a few community announcements.
I'd like to announce the winner of... Sir, you are mistaken.
I am not mistaken and I can prove it. Is that not the massage you gave me this morning?
Message.
That is what I've been saying, you lunatic. Now, do you have a massage for me or not? Is there something wrong with your hand?
In Germany, it is the custom to tip the messenger.
In France, it is custom to kill the messenger. Who gave you this massage? Extortionist. Now, who gave you the massage?
It was a beautiful and darkly mysterious woman with a Russian accent. She had aquiline features, silken hair, and shapely legs. She was professional and slightly distant in her demeanor, but I sensed a certain pathos, a longing in her eyes. She had the unmistakable aura of a woman in love. One could sense that she was trying to suppress her feelings, no doubt out of a sense of duty. She did not give me her name, but I saw the name tag on her luggage. It said Olga Borosova. She also had a diplomatic passport, which means she is probably a Russian agent.
Could you be more specific?
Well, she's wearing shoes.
Ah, now we are getting somewhere. How many shoes?
Two, I think. Bad news?
Why do you say that?
You look troubled.
That is because I am troubled. Wouldn't you be if every nation in the world wanted you dead? They're all afraid of what Dreyfus will do.
Try and look on the bright side.
I wonder what she means by this. Beware Trojans bearing gifts. I never gave a Trojan anything. Why would a Trojan give me something?
Perhaps you're taking it too literally. Sounds to me like she's warning you to be extremely careful not to trust anybody.
I suggest you let me worry about that. After all, I am the chief inspector, and you are not. I develop a sixth sense where danger is concerned.
Guten Tag, mein Herr.
Oh, good day, little German girl.
Would you care for ein Plätzl? Compliments of the Oktoberfest tourist commission.
How kind.
Pete.
As I was saying, I'm constantly on the alert, looking for danger everywhere. Petzl?
Why, yes, I'm famished.
They give me, how do you say, petrol.
You mean gas?
Apparently they give you petrol as well. I must be on my way to my hotel room now. Some people cannot hold their pretzels. Quick 20 winks before Oktoberfest will not hurt. What is it?
It is the manager. I've come to clean the room, yeah.
The room is already clean, yeah?
Please, sir, if I do not clean the room, yeah, I will be fired, yeah?
Very well. Come in.
I will only be a moment, yeah.
Yeah. I was hoping to get some sleep, but if you must clean...
It is my duty.
What is that perfume you are wearing?
It's called Spring Night in Siberia.
A Russian perfume?
Do you like it?
It reminds me of someone special.
Oh, but please, yeah.
Good God, woman, I suggest you get a hold of yourself and do your duty.
You're right.
I hope you realize I have a good mind to report this hotel to the tourist commission.
But darling!
Don't darling me. The toilets don't flush, the sheets have holes in them, and the maids strangle the guests.
But darling, it's me, Olga Brozova.
Don't be funny with me. Olga may be many things, but she's not a one-eyed hunchback.
Surprise!
Olga!
How did you know?
It would take more than a silly hunchback disguise to fool me.
Oh, you big hunk of French intellect. I forgot I was a giant among midgets.
You almost killed me.
Believe me, Babushka, it was nothing personal. I could not do it this time, but if you do not leave Peter at once, he will die.
Dreyfus is a lunatic.
Perhaps, but she also controls the ultimate weapon, thanks to Dr. Fassbender. She says if you are not delivered within 2 days, she will pick another target, like London, Washington, or Moscow.
How she can blame her lunacy on me? It boggles the mind.
Do you love me?
Love is something I do not have much experience to go on, darling. But my heart is making the pity fat.
Could you love me?
I think so.
Then speaking one lover to another, take the evening train to my side. There's a boat waiting there to sail to Trinidad. Tell the captain I have sent you, and he will present you with a fake passport. I will meet you there, and we will live our lives, eating sea bass and making love. If I'm not there, it means I've been captured and executed. In that case, have sea bass for me.
You would do this for me, at the risk of your life?
What can I say? Love makes me crazy.
I am truly touched. This I shall never forget.
Come with me, Jacques.
I cannot. For there are times when a man is liable to say things that will make him forget his duty. I cannot afford to let this be one of those times.
I understand. And you must understand, the next time our eyes meet, one of us will die.
I would say good luck, but it somehow doesn't seem fitting.
Goodbye, Jacques.
Thank you.
Yeah. Das ist der Liechtensteiner Polka, mein Schatz. Polka, mein Schatz. Polka, mein Schatz. Da blieb doch kein Liechtensteiner auf seinem Platz. Auf seinem Platz, mein Schatz.
Man kann ihn schieben, 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 doch und schieben morgen sein.
Man muss sich lieben, lieben, lieben und die Liebe, die ist schon. Oh ja. Yeah. So eine Liechtensteiner Polka, die hat, die macht Rabatt, mein Schatz. Der alte Herr von Liechtenstein,
ja, ja, ja,
der konnte nicht allein sein.
Nein, nein, nein.
Er schickte seinen Boten aus.
Ja, ja, ja.
Schaut mir nach Musikanten aus und schickt ihr mir in Haus. Die Musik liegt er los, da wussten klein und groß. Oh ja, Chicken! Mack, 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 Mark.
Room key, please.
But you have your key.
If I had my key, I would not be asking for it.
But I just gave it to you.
Do you know who I am?
Of course, you're the inspector.
Chief Inspector.
Chief Inspector Clouseau.
Of the Sûreté?
Of the Sûreté.
And do you know how he became Chief Inspector Clouseau of the Sûreté?
No, but I suppose you'll tell me.
I became Chief Inspector Clouseau of the Sûreté by being a first-rate detective. Would you like an example of how a first-rate detective operates?
Do I have a choice?
As a first-rate detective, I would instantly deduce that you are German.
Amazing.
About 38 years old.
39, but I have a young face.
And an alcoholic.
How do you know that?
Because a short time ago, you were so drunk that you gave my key to someone else.
In that case, with all due respect, I suggest that perhaps it is the first-rate detective who is drunk and has forgotten that a short while ago, he came in, picked up his key, and instantly lost it due to a drunken stupor.
And as a first-rate detective, I would like to remind you that if you persist in this argument, I'll be forced to have speaks with your superiors. You will be fired and not be able to buy any more schnapps.
In that case, I have no alternative but to admit my mistake and give you another key.
Merci.
Don't mention it.
I won't.
It is done. Now Drex will be happy, my superiors and Kremlin will be happy, and I, with one swift, cruel act, have forsaken my right to happiness. If I could not be with him in life, I would be with him in death.
Olga!
Do not try to stop me! If I cannot be with them in life, I will be with them in death!
Come to your senses, woman!
Yeah, you're alive!
Of course I'm alive!
But I just killed you!
If I were not dead, you'd not think I'd be the first to know.
Oh, Shock! Shock! It's a miracle! A divine intervention! Someone up there is trying to tell us something.
Who is that dead man in my bed?
I thought it was you.
Oh, my sweet, that was why you were so upset. You thought I had died.
I thought I had killed you.
You? He looks familiar.
He looks like you, except the mustache is crooked.
Tournier.
Tournier?
The bank robber.
Why is he dressed up like you?
It all makes sense now. The desk clerk was not drunk. She did give me a key, but it was not me. It was Tournier. Look.
What?
His hand. A tattoo.
It looks like the Monsheen Trust.
Monsheen?
Yes, an infamous family that ruled Bavaria in the 15th century. I read somewhere that the castle was recently sold.
Castle, that's it.
That's what?
Dreyfus. Everyone seems to have wanted me dead, and now they will have their wish. Help me put him in the bathroom.
Doc, I hope you can forgive me for almost killing you.
Oh, my sweet, I tried to think what would have happened if I arrived a few minutes later. You would have been gone.
I was considered to be the perfect liquidator. No man had ever been able to trap me emotionally. Until now.
What about your duty?
Duty, schmooty. For all I care, I'm becoming a defector. An ex-Russian agent. Will you have me?
There was never enough time. There was always mountains to climb and windmills to joust. I could never stop for love. And now, love is stopped for me.
Let us go away. Let us leave this madness behind.
I cannot.
Then don't.
Not until I apprehend the woman that is my sworn duty to apprehend. Dreyfus.
Hold me, kiss me, love me. For all we know, tomorrow may never come.
I cannot. But there are times when a man may say things that will make him forget his duty. I cannot afford to let this be one of those times.
You have a strong will.
And a stupid brain. Meet me in Rome in 2 days' time on the Via Vesuvius. There's a quaint little hotel there that has this restaurant, world famous for its singing waiters. We will sit there, and as the waiters sing songs of love, we will stare deeply into each other's eyes and think of nothing more than love, life, in the sweetness of the moment.
Be careful, my darling. I will be waiting.
Goodbye.
Bye, Jacques.
Babushka.
Good day.
I'm Professor Guy Gabois, medieval castle authority from Marseille. I understand the Munchin Castle is not far from here. I'd like to have a look at it for my castle research.
I would not advise it.
Why not?
They have strange things going on up there, and they had closed the site since trespassers will be shot.
I see. Do you have a room?
No.
But this is a hotel?
Yes.
And it is out of season?
Yes.
And I don't see any guests?
Last left here yesterday.
Then you tell me why it is that you do not have a room.
Because I don't know what a room is.
Ein Zimmer?
Ah, a room.
That is what I have been saying. Say a doctor lives here?
He's a dentist. He made my teeth for me.
Where can I find this dentist?
He's gone fishing. He probably won't be back until...
You must show me his room immediately.
Why should I?
because I am not Professor Guy Gabois. I am Chief Inspector Jacques Lusseau of the Sûreté. It is important that you show me the Dr. Zimmer immediately.
Very well, come along.
I demand some
Chief Inspector Jacques Lusseau, disarrêté.
Thank God!
Give me another. Get my daughter out of here. I have to stop driving.
No, don't let him go. He's going to sabotage the doomsday machine.
Margot, it must be done. And I'm the only one who can do it. Now go with this man. You'll be safe.
Wait. Where is this debut machine?
What? Why?
It is my sworn duty to apprehend Dreyfus. And you want to sabotage the Funde device. I think I know a way to kill two stones with one bird. Come along. Dreyfus, I arrest you in the name of the law.
Drop it, Frenchie.
Who are you calling Frenchie the... Frenchie, stop it, drop it.
Oh, my dreams are coming true. Now, should I kill Lusseau first and then destroy him? Decision. Drop the gun!
Olga!
You didn't think everything was left you? What is the meaning of this?
It is the end of your sordid dreams for world domination.
Oh, dear. Your shoe is untied.
Good, Dad.
There's someone coming up behind you?
What is this trick in the book?
Your fly is down.
No.
Hot letter, soft machine.
Pizza pie.
That's amore.
When
When the stars seem to shine like you had too much wine.
Not so more.
Hello, it's a customer. Can I please do the customer?
Come here.
I want to do the customer.
Before you can become a waiter here, you have to at least be able to do this. Mana tu sole, qui veroine, o sole mio, sta in fronte a te.
Now the easy part.
O sole.
Thank you.